This is Rick with Cybermedics, and we're here today to talk about Gmail, specifically account protection and account recovery methods and backup procedures to make sure that your account is accessible in case you lose access for some reason. So first thing you want to do is log into the account, put in your password. And this is secured with a hardware security key. Highly recommend yubikey security keys. There's a link to the video above about yubikeys if you're interested in securing your account so that they cannot be hacked by someone knowing your password. Select next. And we'll come over here and we'll say manage your Google account. Come into the security section, select security. And the first thing we want to do is look at two-step verification. So second factor authentication is a second type of method. Once you log in with your password, you will have to confirm through this method. If it's not on, I recommend that you turn it on. So the first part here is the hardware security key. This is where you would add a security key. Just click down here and say add a security key. You physically plug it into the device. You get two prompts from Google. You'll type in the PIN of your key. Once you type in the PIN, you'll select OK, and then the key would be added to your account. So, once you've added your keys, this second factor authentication method that you can use is something called an Authenticator app. This is an application that you download to your phone, and based upon you logging into your account, a code would be generated on the Authenticator app. That code would then be plugged into your account. So presently I have an Authenticator application on here. You get that through your Google Play Store or your iOS store. The next second factor authentication, they have it under two-step verification, but I don't really think of this as two-step verification. It's more recover your account if for some reason you can't use your password or you can't use your Authenticator app or you've lost your hardware key. You can generate something called backup codes. Now, these are one-time use codes that can be used in lieu of a password to get access to your account. The best thing to do with these is to print them out on a piece of paper and put them in a safe, or copy them and put them in an encrypted file that you would always have access to. That way, if you lost your other second factor authentications, or for some reason your password, you couldn't get in through your password, these codes can be used. They're one-time codes again, so once you used it, you'll have to go on to the next code. Okay, so now once you've generated your codes, you have your Authenticator app set up, and you have your hardware security key, that takes care of all the two-step verifications. So we'll go back into manage your Google account, come into security. Next thing we want to look at is a recovery phone. So if you needed to get access to your account and for some reason you couldn't get in through your password or your second factor authentications, if you have a phone number associated with your account, Google can send you a recovery, six-digit recovery code to allow you to get access to your account. Now, you can add your cell phone number here, but think about this. You're going to add your cell phone number, and the scenario is most likely you've lost your phone. You're trying to get back access to your account. So if you put in your cell phone number here, you might want to consider your significant other or your best friend's phone number. That way, if you've lost your phone and lost access to your account, you could rely on that other number. Even better is you could link it to a Google Voice number. The Google Voice number, the advantage of that is it's internet accessible. So let's say your cell phone gets lost, but you still have access to the Google Voice number on the account that that phone number is associated with, then that number could be used to access the account. So once you've added your phone number here, you can say cancel or next and add the phone number. So let's go back. The next thing is a recovery email. So you want to make sure that you have a backup email address associated with the account so that you could use that alternate account to receive a code in case that you couldn't get access to your account. So that's important also. Summarizing, we went into two-step verification. We turned that on. We added a hardware security key. We downloaded the authentication app and installed that on our phone. We generated backup codes. The one that we didn't talk about was Google Prompts. Basically, what this is if you log in and you have another device that you're already logged into, Google can send a prompt to say yes or no, do you want to authorize the login? The next thing we did is we went into the recovery phone number and recommended that you add a phone. Better yet, add a Google Voice number tied to an alternate cell phone number that in case you lost your primary phone, you would still be able to authenticate to the account. And then we talked about the recovery email, adding a recovery email, and highly recommend that that email also is secured with a hardware security key. We'd be particularly interested in your backup methods for access to your Gmail accounts. Have you had to recover an account? What was your experience? If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. Hope you will consider subscribing and have a great and wonderful automation day.